What we've been doing is looking at the genetics of drug production in cannabis sativa because, like all members of this species, it does contain some level of THC, tetrahydrocannabinol, the active ingredient in marijuana. The level of this drug is quite high in marijuana plants and very, very low, but detectable in hemp plants. And that's a problem for law enforcement because distinguishing between hemp and marijuana is a difficult thing. We've known for some time that THC is present in these tiny hairs that cover the flowers of the marijuana plant. Our study has shown that the genes that are involved in producing that drug are turned on in these hairs. The genes are active in the hairs of the marijuana plant. The next step in our research is to identify the genes that control the development of these plant hairs. If we can silence those genes, then we can produce a plant that is not only drug-free, but visually distinctive, easily recognizable as distinct from the marijuana plant. There's tremendous public interest in the cannabis plant. I can't think of another plant that is so regarded as a miracle by some and a menace by others. There's interest among farmers in the Midwest in crop alternatives to corn and soybeans. Hemp was once a thriving industry here in Minnesota as a source of pulp for making paper, rope fiber, and so forth. Hemp seeds are also a source of nutritious oils that also have applications in industrial processes, such as perhaps the production of biodiesel. And currently, both hemp seed and hemp fiber are imported to the United States because all cannabis plants are considered controlled substances. By changing the appearance and drug content of plants, we hope to engineer a variety that could be cultivated on domestic soil and serve as a renewable source of some materials that are currently derived from fossil fuels, such as plastic fibers. The genetic machinery that produces cannabinoids, not just THC, but a whole variety of molecules, are of great interest to the pharmaceutical industry in the development of new potential therapies for pain, nausea, and so forth. So here we are beside a railroad track in Minnesota. We've got a whole variety of weedy species coming up. Here is a cannabis plant that was once cultivated throughout Minnesota. It escaped from cultivation as long as 150 years ago. And even though this plant has not been grown by farmers for 50 years in the state, you can see that it is still thriving in weedy habitats like this.